Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel Mission Net Physics Exam. And guys, today in this video I am going to discuss a very important question of mathematical physics, and that is from most expected topic based questions. So let's talk about it, let's start the discussion about this question. But before that, even I would like to tell you that if you are new on this channel, you can subscribe this channel just by clicking on the subscribe button below this video. Also guys, you can click on the bell icon to get the notifications for the new videos I will upload on this channel, because all the videos which are available on this channel are going to help you to prepare for your upcoming CSIR NET exam as well as for the GATE physics exam. So yeah, you can watch all other videos as well. Now let's talk about the question we are going to discuss in this video. So that is going to have a form, and basically it is from the contour integration topic. So the form of integration which is given to you is integration from 1 to infinity, okay, and root x minus 1, clear, upon 1 plus x to the power, like whole power 2 and dx. So this is the form of integration which is given to you. Now the point is, generally we are going to get different type of integration based questions. So how we will work on this question to get the right answer? Let's talk about the steps now, and I hope that this discussion will provide you another idea and will help you to understand any such question easily and to work on it, clear? So let's talk about it, like what are the steps we will take and how we will think, how we will relate that, okay, this is the step I need to take to solve this question. So guys, first of all, you can see that the integration limits are from 1 to infinity. And generally, based on contour integration, the questions which we consider, in those questions, either we are going to have integration over C, that is a particular contour will be given to us, or integration from minus infinity to plus infinity, or sometimes even 0 to infinity, because by just checking that whether the function is even or odd, we can convert the limits, okay. Next, we are going to have the integration limits from 0 to 2 pi, clear, or the open contour based question can be there. So there are different type of questions from the contour integration topic. Now if we are going to talk about the given question, in this we are having the integration limits from the 1 to infinity. So when we are talking about this 1 to infinity range, guys, how we can convert this limit into the limits for which we already know that these are the steps we need to take, and that's how we can just get the final answer, clear? So for that, you can take your first step as by considering x minus 1 as z, okay? Now it's up to you that what you want to consider, but I will give you a suggestion here which will make the things more simple and more easy for you. What is that suggestion? See, here they have provided the square root of x minus 1. The point is, if I am just considering it as z, I will get root z there. But if I will consider it as z square, I will be able to simplify it and get just z out of that square root term after simplifying it. So what is more better? By considering it z square, we will get a simple form. So we are going to consider it as z square. So when we are considering x minus 1 is equal to z square, what we will get from here? Dx is equal to 2z dz, clear? So you can replace this dx with this 2z dz, clear? And another thing is, what is gonna be the change in the limits? Let's talk about it now. If x is equal to 1 limit already given to you, what will be the value of z you will get? 1 minus 1 will be 0. Okay, so now your lower limit will be 0, corresponding to this expression which you have considered. And when you will consider x is equal to infinity, then even the z value will be infinity. Done. And the function's form is going to become, replace x minus 1 with z square, you will get z upon. What will be the value of x you will get from here? Just take this 1 on the other side, you will get 1 plus z square. Okay, so 1 plus z square and whole square, that's what you are going to get. And in place of dx, you will put what? This 2z dz, clear? Now what is going to be the form which you will get? It will be integration 0 to infinity 2, let's take it outside, z square upon 2 plus z square and whole square, clear? And dz. Now the point is, you will have to just take the simple steps. What are these steps? firstly you have to find the poles. What will be the poles you will get? When you are equating the z square plus 2 with 0, you will get z square is equal to minus 2, which means z is equal to plus minus root minus 2, which means it's gonna be plus minus root 2 iota, okay, or iota root 2. So you are getting two poles, one is plus iota root 2, another one is minus iota root 2. One more thing, guys, here you can see that you are going to have the 2 into integration limit 0 to infinity. So you can even write it as minus infinity to plus infinity, because normally we solve the integration for the minus infinity to plus infinity case. So you can consider it is gonna be the even function, okay, and corresponding to that you can make the conversion or you can make the changes in the limits. So you will try to write it in this form, and in this type of contour integration based questions we consider the poles which are lying in the upper half of the complex plane. So only this one will be lying on the upper half of the complex plane, or even if we are going to have the poles which are lying on the purely real axis, we consider them. But right now we are just having two poles, out of which the one which is plus iota root 2 will exist in the upper half of the complex plane, somewhere here you can say. Done. So you will consider this one and you will find the residue on this pole. Now to find the residue, you have to check its order. So order is what? 2. That means you have to use the formula to find the residue of order n pole. Okay, that formula you will have to use, and that is 1 upon factorial n minus 1 dn minus 1 dz n minus 1 z to the power this z minus a to the power n and fz. Okay, and at the end put z is equal to a, that is the pole value. Clear? And that's how you can get the answer. So guys, in this way, just by solving this answer and by taking all these steps, you will easily be able to reach to the final answer. And integration formula which you will use, that's gonna be 2 pi iota into sum of residue. Okay, 2 pi iota into sum of residue. So just by taking these steps, you can easily reach to the answer. But the initial steps were very important. That is how to change the limits, how to get the final answer and expression. Okay. And thank you so much everyone for watching this video till the end. I hope each and everything will be clear to all of you. Now I'm just going to provide you the idea about the upcoming Unacademy Plus courses. So guys, soon revision courses will start on Unacademy Plus, which will help you a lot to prepare for your upcoming CSIR Net Physics exam. Also guys, by using and by applying the referral code, that is Anjali Arora, you will be able to get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. So if you are going to take the Unacademy Plus subscription, you can use and apply the referral code, that is Anjali Arora, no space in between. Use it, apply it, and get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. Also guys, after taking the Unacademy Plus subscription, you will get so many benefits like weekly quizzes, doubt clearing sessions, mock tests, and PDF of important notes will be available to you. So I hope all the information which I have provided you in this video today will be helpful for you, and all these things together will help you a lot to do the best preparation for your upcoming CSIR Net Physics exam. Thank you so much everyone for watching this video till the end. Thank you.